Hello and welcome back. Today I would like to show you how I imported the Hanging Gardens Wonder from Civilization 6 into vanilla Minecraft. Quick disclaimer, I didn't write any of the software used here, and I can't guarantee that they don't have malware. Always do your own research before downloading anything. First, you do have to buy Civilization 6 on Steam. Then I go to the Tools tab, which can be found in the Library menu. I install the Sid Meier's Civilization 6 Development Assets and Tools. I open the tools and click Mod Buddy. I want to use the Asset Editor, but as you can see, the option is grayed out. I make a new empty mod. It does not matter what you name it. Now I can launch the Asset Editor under the Tools menu. I click on the Assets tab and search for the name of my building. Wonders have the prefix WON, and there are similar naming conventions for the other files. I note the name because I will need it later. Once it is open, I can see the building to the right and verify that it is correct. I click on the cube icon to open the Geometries tab. There should only be one entry, which I double click to open the details. I find the meshes with the worked state, which are the completed and unpillaged versions. I will need the building and foliage textures. I double click on the material field to open a new tab with more information. Under the coffee mug icon, I look at the name next to base color. It is 1 Hanging Gardens B in this case. Then I go back to the first tab and double click on the foliage material to find the base color is 1 Plants B. I found out later that I also need the opacity texture, which is 1 Plants OP. Once you know the file names, you can close the Mod Buddy program. I make a new folder in My Documents / Blender Projects. Then navigate to Program Files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Sid Meier's Civ 6 SDK Assets, Civ 6, Pantry, and Geometries. I search for 1 Hanging Gardens EM.FGX, which is the same name as the asset we opened earlier. Copy this to the folder you just created. Then go back to the Pantry folder and open Textures. I find the DDS files for the building and foliage. I copy these into my new folder as well. I downloaded Civ Nexus 6 from Civ Fanatics and extracted the zip file. Run the executable to open the FBX. I can click View to see the model, although it doesn't have any textures. I'm sure there's a way to add them, but it's not necessary. Just make sure the model is the one you expected and close the viewer. In the first window, I click the Additional Actions tab and make sure the export file type is set to Civ Nexus 6. Then click Export Current Model so the CN6 will be generated in the folder with the FBX file. Now I can close Civ Nexus. I will be using Blender, which is a free and open source program for creating and editing 3D models. Now, to open the CN6 file, you need to download an add-on for Blender, which I also found on the Civ Fanatics forum. In Blender, under File, I open the User Preferences. At the bottom, I click Install Add-on from File. Then select the zip we just downloaded and click Install Add-on from File in the top right. It should be installed automatically, but you can make sure by going to the User category to check the box next to Import Civ Nexus 6. Create a new project and right-click while holding Shift on the cube, pyramid, and circle. Press Delete, then the Enter key to clear the workspace. Now, under File, I import the CN6 of our hanging gardens. To show textures on the model, you hold Alt and Z, but it is completely white. To add the colors, I right-click the building to select it. There should be a thin orange line around the border. At the bottom, click Object Mode and change it to Edit Mode. The faces now have orange triangles on them. I click the small cube icon in the bottom left corner and choose the UV/Image Editor. You will see gray triangles on a white background. In the menu that appeared, I click Image and Open Image. Now I find the DDS for the building and click Open Image again. Now the background has changed to the wall's texture. I don't really know why there are floating triangles outside the image. Click the cube again to change back to 3D view, and then select Object Mode to clear the orange overlay so you can clearly see the building. The trees and bushes are still white, so I right-click them and repeat the same steps, this time using the plant's texture. Now I deselect all and click Save As to create the blend file. This allows me to open the project again without having to re-import the model. As well, I click Export under the File menu and select the Wavefront OBJ format. I select the folder containing my textures. This will generate an OBJ and an MTL file. I download the Poly2Vox and Slab 6 programs from the author Ken Silverman's site and unzip them. For convenience, I copy the Poly2Vox executable into the folder with the OBJ and MTL files. Then I make a new file with the .bat extension and edit it with Notepad. On the first line, I type Poly2Vox and then the name of the OBJ file. To keep the console open so I can see if any errors are thrown, I type pause in all caps on the second line. If you don't use Windows, you will need to make a shell script instead. I run the bat file and see that the DDS image format is not supported. First, I tried using an online converter to create PNGs. It came out with a bluish tint though, because the red and blue values are flipped. I ended up using GIMP, which is a free open source image editor similar to Photoshop. I also had to download the latest GIMP DDS plugin from the Google Code Archive, which worked with GIMP 2.10 and probably does on later versions too. extract the zip file to the GIMP plugins folder, which will be something like program files, GIMP 2, lib, GIMP 2.0, and plugins. Now you can open GIMP and import the DDS files. Click Export As and save them as PNGs. I could have remapped these textures using Blender, but it was easier to just open the MTL file and replace .dds with .png. Save it and run the poly to vox bat again. Now it should say the textures were found and the KV6 file is created. Then run the slab6 executable and open this file to see how it looks in voxel form. It looks good, but I want it to be bigger. By default, the longest side of the build will be 128 blocks. To change this, I open the poly to vox bat file and add /v256 after the file name to double the size of the building. The last step is converting it into a Minecraft schematic. I used the program KV6.2 schematic, which I found on archive.org. Click Advanced Audio Coding to get the jar file. Double-clicking the file will create a pop-up. I select the default palette and use colored clay blocks. Then navigate to my KV6 file, and finally choose the output location. Now I can open this schematic with MCEdit 2, which works up to Minecraft version 1.12.2. Of course, you can also use WorldEdit for this. When I launch MCEdit, it throws an error because the selected world is 1.13. You can just click Continue and select your 1.12 world before it pops back up. Simply import the schematic, click Confirm, and wait for it to process. Then click Save World and close MCEdit. Now I can finally open Minecraft to see the results. Remember, you can always upgrade the save to 1.14. So you can use all the new blocks. The gardens look pretty good, but I don't like how the entrances are diagonal. To fix this, I open it back up in Blender and click Rotate. When I move my mouse over, it will rotate the build freely. Left-click to release your mouse and a window will open. I check the Z-axis option and change the rotation to 30 followed by a D 4 degrees. I used the red and green arrows to help me line it up. This is still not perfect, but it's close enough. As you can see, the stairs and arch doorways are now straight. At this point, I noticed that the bushes were hanging way too far off the walls. I could see in the asset viewer that it was not supposed to be like that. I found the opacity layer and copied it from the pantry folder as well. I know there is a way to apply masks in Blender, but it was easier for me to do it with GIMP. I opened the background image, right-click the layer, and select Add Layer Mask. The type doesn't matter, but I chose black full transparency. Right-click on the layer to make sure Edit Mask is enabled. You can see that adding white allows the image to show through. Then I copy the opacity image and paste it onto the mask layer. The leaves should be cut out now. Right-click the floating selection and select Anchor Layer. Now you can export this as a PNG and apply it to the foliage mesh in Blender like we did before. I was able to make the black transparent by clicking on the materials in the top right, checking the box next to transparency, and selecting the Z transparency option. However, when I loaded it into Poly2Vox, it did not register the opacity. At least now I can remove the black terracotta around the green to create the shape of the bushes. I decided to stop here and upload the unedited schematic to Planet Minecraft. There is still a lot of work to do to make the hanging gardens look really nice, but that will be for the next episode. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.